Recording in progress.
So the Most Happy Fella became tremendously successful based upon the I Love Lucy episode that ran. It's a very complicated piece to do. It's almost totally sung through, which was totally unusual in its day. But again, the competition for My Fair Lady truly overshadowed it. And it's been
the most happy fella in the whole Napa Valley. In the whole Napa Valley, the most happy man has to be. Look at my Rosabella.
He's the most happy fella.
Look at my Rosabella.
Look at his Rosabella.
She was saying to me a photograph, and she was asking me for mine.
Oh, mine, that's a mine, that's a mine, that's a mine.
Standing on the corner, watching all the girls go by.
Brother, you don't know a nicer occupation. Matter of fact, neither do I.
Then standing on the corner, watching all the girls, watching all the girls, watching all the girls go by.
To your life, a waitress earns her pay. I've been on my feet, my poor, poor feet, all day long today. Doing my blue plate special ballet.
Joey, Joey, Joey. Too long in one town, and the harvest times come and gone.
You're from Big D. Oh, I can guess by the way you draw and the way you dress. You're from Big D.
My, oh yes, I mean Big D, little A, double L, A, S.
And that spells Dallas, my darling, darling Dallas. Don't it give you pleasure to confess that you're from Big D?
My, oh yes,
I mean Big D, little A, double L, A. Big D, little A, double L, A. Big D, little A, double L, A, yes.
Well, the Music Man, of course, was everybody's feel-good musical. And, you know, Robert Preston was not the person that originally they wanted. Meredith Willson actually spent 7 years writing the piece about his, you know, it's not autobiographical, but about life in Iowa that he remembered it as a young boy. And, of course, it's about this scam artist who comes to town and the town really reforms him. Well, Robert Preston, as I said, was not the first choice. The first choice, if you can believe it or not, was Cary Grant. But Cary Grant was not interested in doing this. And Robert Preston, when they cast him, they were doubtful, the producers, that he could pull this off. You know, he was a second-tier Western star in the movies. And he knew this was the perfect part for him. And he was so willing to take it on that he agreed that he would do it and allow himself to be fired with 24 hours notice without any compensation, which was a big risk on his part. Well, we all know the story of this. And it was also Barbara Cook who falls down there below the title. And this really is the first time she's in a major big hit. So in any event, the Music Man is everybody's favorite. And this is Barbara Cook, as shown on the Bell Telephone Hour during the run of The Music Man about 1958.
There were bells on the hill, but I never heard them ringing. No, I never heard them at all till there was you. There were birds in the sky, but I never saw them winging. No, I never saw.
Lie the rose all
Barbara Cook always was one of course, this is where she started. But at the same time that the Music Man opened, everybody's feel-good musical, West Side Story opened, which was very challenging for everybody. The fact that it was so violent, the fact that two people are killed at the end of the first act and the leading character is killed at the end of the play. This had never happened before in a Broadway musical. I mean, even in Carousel, where Billy Bigelow dies, he comes back at the end and you sort of don't realize that he's gone. West Side Story, the music was considered hyperactive, dissonant, and blaring. Everything about it, it was sort of like the Rent of its day. You either got it or you didn't. And West Side Story fought for an audience for 2.5 years. Ed Sullivan presenting it many times to try to get audiences to come because he recognized how different West Side Story was. Of course, this was Leonard Bernstein. Arthur Lawrence wrote the script, and Jerome Robbins totally created the idea. And Jerome Robbins actually took advantage of his partners by claiming extra percentage points sort of in the middle of the night before it opened and blackmailing Hal Prince. Either he got more money or the show, he would close it. Well, you know, when you've got an investment going, you sort of cave. And this was typical of the behavior that Jerome Robbins consistently exhibited. Meanwhile, the original lyricists were Betty Comden and Adolph Green, who felt that it was wrong for them, which is how Stephen Sondheim got involved. He meets Arthur Lawrence by chance at an event, and Arthur Lawrence gets him an audition with Bernstein. Now, Sondheim, being, you know, rather egotistical at the age of 26, couldn't understand why he had to audition for anybody. And it was Oscar Hammerstein, his mentor, who said, you know what, don't play hard to get for Leonard Bernstein. That's not necessarily a good career strategy. And of course, Sondheim goes in, they hit it off, and the rest is history. You know, again, the violence of West Side Story was something that was very concerning to people. They didn't quite know what to make of it. This is the original. This is Carol Lawrence and Larry Kurt. I'm not sure which TV show it was on because it is in color, and that would have only been available on NBC.
Playing spring. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria.
I hope you found that interesting, you know, to see the originals portray, you know, Tony and Maria. They were both really too old, but, you know, it's great to see that original cut. Well, the Flower Drum song was Rodgers and Hammerstein's attempt to try to create a hit. They had had two miserable flops. One in 1953 with Me and Juliet, the next one, 1956, Pipe Dream, neither worked. So they decided maybe The King and I was an inspiration and they should go do something exotic again. Well, they go and they buy the rights to a book called The Flower Drum Song about the Chinese immigration experience in San Francisco. And quite frankly, you can't even use the script today. It's so stereotypically badly portrayed. But the good news is the score was wonderful and Ed Sullivan got behind it, where there's this very good example of the music that they wrote. The problem with the Flower Drum Song in 1958 was they didn't cast Asians universally in the parts, but we were supposed to believe that all of these people were Chinese. Well, you decide for yourself as you watch the great music from the Flower Drum Song here.
A flower drum song. This is a Chinese flower drum. While I sing, I will caress the flowers. If my song is good, give me a little applause. If my song is bad, give me applause too. 100 media miracles are happening every day, and those who say they don't agree are those who do not hear or see. 100 media miracles are happening. Writes a poem, other writes music to fit the poem. A singer puts words and music into his heart and throw his heart to the world. That is a miracle. In Flower Drum Song, nephew discusses a Chinese love poem with his aunt. That is a miracle. Here are two singers, Juanita Ho and Ed Kenny.
It starts along the Huang Ho Valley.
Ah, yes, I remember.
Along the Huang Ho Valley, where young men walk and dream of
flower boat with singing girls came drifting down the stream.
I saw the face of only one come drifting down the stream. You are beautiful, small and shy. You are the girl whose eyes met mine just as your boat sailed by. This I know of you, nothing more. You are the girl whose eyes met mine passing the river. And bright,
miracle is the miracle that happens every time a song is sung by my friend Pat Suzuki. What she wants, she will sing it to you of her disappointment, Miss Arabella Hall. Will tell you what is their favorite day in a week and why. Pat Suzuki and Larry Blyden.
Now that we're going to be married, I'll keep imagining things that can happen to people when they are wearing gold rings.
Being together each morning, sharing our coffee and toast. That's only one of the pictures. Here's one I'll picture most. Sunday, sweet Sunday, with nothing to do. Lazy and lovely, my one day with you. Hazy and happy, rip through the day, dreaming the hours away. While all the funny papers lie or fly around the place, I will try my kisses on your funny face. Don't
lazy and
Well, the flower drum song, the score was great. And, you know, just the script is just not appropriate in today's world. It was rewritten a few years ago, but still, it doesn't really play well. Of course, Gypsy, considered maybe one of the greatest musicals ever written with one of the greatest female parts ever, was designed for Merman. Jerome Robbins and Arthur Lawrence, when they realized they were going to write a musical based upon the life of Gypsy Rose Lee, they knew full well that this was going to be about Gypsy Rose Lee's mother, this woman who would sacrifice the lives of her children to achieve the dreams that she never achieved for herself. Well, it opened to great reviews. It's the greatest performance Merman ever gave. And today it's a cherished piece of Broadway musical theater. Sondheim was wanted to originally write the words and music himself, but Merman wouldn't hear of it. She liked his lyrics from West Side, but she didn't want to trust him to the music, as he had never written a Broadway musical before.
Now, all I need is a girl.
And that girl, ladies and gentlemen, is the star of the Broadway musical Gypsy, singing Everything's Coming Up Roses, exactly as she does it in the show, Miss Ethel Merman.
Well, it opened against The Sound of Music, and believe it or not, Mary Martin and Ethel Merman were vying for the Best Actor Award that year, and Mary Martin wins. And when Merman was asked about it, she said, well, how do you expect to beat a nun anyway? Well, The Sound of Music is not really the best Rodgers and Hammerstein musical because Oscar didn't write the script. The script was written actually Lindsay and Krauss, who wrote Life with Father. But and Mary Martin was really way too old to be playing the part, but it certainly was interesting. And, you know, the music may be some of Roger's best. This was from an Ed Sullivan Christmas show. I think you'll get a kick out of this.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rodgers and Hammerstein came into town this year with The Sound of Music, which is the story of the Trapp family of singers. And it's one of the greatest shows, of course, they've ever written, and they've written the greatest. It's gay, it's amusing, it's got a great pace to it. But occasionally in the show, there are moments that I thought were particularly fitted for our inclusion in a Christmas show. So I took two of these moments from the show involving the nuns to whom Mary Martin goes as a postulant. And here are, here is the choir or the chorale. So let's have a wonderful hand for these fine sound, the fine, they're the greatest in the world, Sound of Music singers. Won't you please?
Yeah.
I thought you'd get a kick out of that. And here.
Edelweiss, every morning you greet me, small and white, clean and bright, you look happy to meet me. Blossom of snow, may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever.
Well, as the 1960s opened, there was a new crop of composers. Of course, on the upper right, there's Stephen Sondheim. On the bottom right, there's Jerry Herman. In the center, you have Kander and Hebb. On the left, you have Bach and Harnack. And then you have Frank Lesser. And this would probably be a great place to stop. And we can pick this up again next week right here. So let me stop the share. I don't know if anybody has anything you want to ask. I do see a comment here. In the chat. Oh, I didn't know that. So I'm glad about the story about Rodgers and Hammerstein going to get guidance from the nuns. We will be on next Friday, and I look forward to seeing everybody then. And I don't know if anybody has any questions. I hope you all noticed Some Like It Hot has gotten rave reviews. And it's really something to see. I have a trip going in May. It's on May the 6th. It's one not to miss. Edelweiss was Mary Martin and Theodore Bickel, the originals. So if you really want to see a great, good time, kind of old-fashioned musical with a twist, Some Like It Hot is absolutely amazing. And we've already announced our trip to the Berkshires. It's really selling quickly. So if that's something you want to do in August, please reach out. But definitely consider Some Like It Hot. It's absolutely, it's so good, I can't even believe it. Anyway, rave reviews all over. I hope you all had fun today, and I'll see you all next week. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.